Greetings, my lovelies. Hi, it's Emmy. Welcome back to another You Made What. Today I have another prison ramen recipe that comes from this book, Prison Ramen. So if you missed my other prison food recipes, I shall put the link down below. So today's recipe is Avery's Jailhouse Hole Burrito. And like all these recipes, it's very inventive and uses foods that you can get from the commissary or from the cafeteria. Oh, and if you like these kind of fun experimental recipes, be sure to subscribe. All right, let's go ahead and start making this. We're gonna begin with a chili flavored ramen noodle, and we're gonna crush up the noodles before we open it. Another thing that's really common in prison is that you don't have things like bowls, so bags are often used to cook your food. So I'm going to use this bag to cook the ramen. We're gonna take the seasoning packet out, pull that off, and we're gonna save this little slip. And we're also gonna save the seasoning powder as well. We're gonna use some hot water to moisten our ramen noodles. So in jail, the water would probably be just hot tap water. Next, we're gonna use our little piece of seasoning pack and use it as a twist tie to hold our bag together. Twist that up and use that to cinch that up. Can you just twist it? Yeah, I'm impressed. So while our noodles are cooking, we're gonna make the rest of this burrito. Next, we're gonna need an 8-ounce bag of jalapeno flavored popcorn. The recipe says to pour 3/4 of it out. Let's give this a taste. That's pretty good. Really ranchy. More than jalapeno, but tasty. So basically now what we're doing is we're making the stuffing for our burrito. So inside this bag, we're going to add the ramen seasoning. This is chili flavor. I'm gonna add a handful of cheese flavored crackers. I happen to have goldfish. I think I'm gonna crush those up a little bit. Add a handful of takis or some kind of rolled spicy chip. And crush that up a little bit. We're gonna use a 1/4 cup of squeezable cheese. I'm gonna save half for the inside, so use about that. And then we're gonna add some hot sauce. It says 1/2 cup, but I'm just gonna do it to taste. So I'm gonna add a combination of sriracha and Tabasco. Okay. Is crush up a 1-ounce bag of Cheetos. Use the bag as your mixing vessel. See if our ramen noodles are cooked. And they're pretty. They're good. So I'm gonna do this prison style to drain out the water. I'm just gonna poke some holes in this and get some of that excess water out. There we go. Now we're going to combine that to the rest of this concoction. All right. Now we're going to give this a thorough mixing. I'm going to pour this out in a bowl so you can see what it looks like. It's kind of amazing. And that's going to be the center of a burrito. Next, we're going to grab a tortilla, spread the remaining cheese on the bottom, and then our filling. This is a good amount for one burrito, I think. So then we're gonna roll this bad boy up and give it a taste. All right, that looks like a burrito. So I've just cut it in half, and I have to say, that looks a lot like a burrito. I mean, the ramen almost looks like rice. You've got the oozy cheese. It's got the right color. Let's give that a taste, here we go. And of all the recipes that I've made from this book, this one to me is the tastiest. Because most of these recipes contain highly processed foods, they taste really processed. But this actually tastes pretty delicious. What I really enjoy is the different amounts of heat. You've got the spicy takis, you've got the spicy Tabasco and sriracha, and the spicy seasoning packet from the ramen. The cheese and the wet ramen hold everything together, so it seems like you're eating something kind of like rice or refried beans or something. But the cheese also gives it a nice kind of richness, so it makes it feel like you're not just eating reconstituted chips, which essentially you're doing, right? But this is totally tasty. Mm-hmm. And the popcorn works really well in there too. It rehydrates a little bit, so it gets a little bit of a chew. And you get an occasional crunch from the Takis and the Cheeto. It's really actually quite scrumptious. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed yet another prison recipe. Let me know in the comments below if you want to see more or if there's any specific prison recipes that you've heard of that you'd like me to try. Let me know. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed that one. I hope you guys learned something. Don't forget to leave a comment, give a thumbs up if you like this video, and don't forget to subscribe if you're not subbed already. And yeah, I shall see you in my next video. Toodaloo, take care, bye. Hello, my lovelies, it's Emmy, welcome back. Today I'll be doing a spicy food taste test, more specifically, comparing Flaming Hot and Habanero. And oh, let me pour these guys out, and these have a completely different color. Oh, look at that one. That one's like a little hand.